Is Ivor's going over?
The Cork and Kerry Mountains.
Is that right? Is the accent all right, Frank? The Cork and Kerry fucking mountains. Is that it? No.
As I was going over the Cork and Kerry Mountain, thought Captain Farrell, not quite rocking. We'll be right back.
didn't look that all those years ago, he said.
It's down the key there on mandolin, thank you.
Did it tune that up? It's a bit wafty, Andrew, that one. Tennis? Oh, yeah, bugger.
By the way, is anybody in from the 66 course?
Ring in the ears, have we got time for it? I've got a warm time. I don't think we can do Patti Smith, actually.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, why I have to go somewhere, the lads would like to play Flight of the Wingless Bat. Thank you very much indeed.
Yes, Uncle Keith has got to go for a wee, because he's had a few beers, like we all have, and it's difficult, isn't it? These wires. It's a heat, isn't it? I'm not used to it now. Discerning amongst you, of which there are many. Help me sit down here.
All the way from Australia, you're going to need that and do a couple of three songs, weren't you? No wonder bloody well Barry coming off to bloody Ireland. You know about this.
Fucking marvellous. Our last gig, and we have to.
Yeah, but the real event is going to have to do all the way across to try lazy out. Do one more tune.
Thank you.
Yes, I do.
This song called Ringing in the Ears.
Oh yeah.
And this is the song for all our friends from Clayham, bless their hearts.
Now we've got to practice this.
It's the falsetto, isn't it? Chris Murphy's is going down well.
No.
Are you reeling in the years? Stowing away the time.
That was a song called Badge. We'd like to do some famous endings of songs now. Bloody Alice Murphy's just going down well. I'll tell you what, I've got, how much have we got up here?
3 and 6.
I've got 50. I've got 85 pence.
You'll get a third of a pint, Keith. 35 A third of a pint. Anyone near the bar that can get Keith a third of a pint?
Oh, no. Where's all this ale coming from? Look, he's got 3 bleeding pints there. And he never pays for them.
Popular, you see, Pete, popular.
Suits you, sir. Oh. Oh. Coming from Winter.
What?
Any requests?
Thank you.
Well, I'm crazy about my baby. Gotta know his name.
Wait, 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 wait
next one. Chicken, I want one for my tea. I haven't had one since Easter, and it's nearly 3:15. So, can have a bit of quiet, I'll tell you a story now. About 6 weeks ago, I was awoken in the morning at about 3:30 with this buzzing noise downstairs.
In your head?
Hey?
Just at the gate, there was a buzzing noise in your head?
No, in the hallway downstairs. Now, I thought, this is unusual, because it sounds like the burglar alarm, which it was. So I went downstairs, turned it off, and went back to bed again. The following morning, the same happened again, so I thought, hang on, I better get the bloody well electrician in there, the guy who sorts all these things out. And it's very dry talking. It's a sign of a pint of Murphy's anywhere, please.
Frank, are you okay? I love you, Frank.
So anyway, this carried on for about 4 weeks, and a guy down the road called David came up to sort it out, and he says, right, the trouble is, you've got a problem with the circuit board in your alarm system. Okay, David, you are a time-served electrician. He's also an industrial electrician, whatever you call it, or a contractor, or what sort of thing. Shut your mouth. Hey, hang on.
The climax to this.
So anyway, he came in, we've paid about £200 for this new board and everything, and we got it sussed out. So I thought, great, no more problems. The next morning, it happened again. So I said to Dave, So I went to work the following morning, and I was saying to Dave about a mate of mine at work, and I was saying, what a great thing this new bloody system, alarm system I've got. Absolutely got. I said, you can use it for anything. You can use it for even a fire alarm. And I thought, shit. Basically, what happened is the battery had run down in the bloody raw fire alarm system. So about £300 later, it all boiled down to a Wilco's 75 pence bastard battery.
They don't tell you things like that when you buy them, Keith, do they?
That's right, isn't it, Angie? Well, also, we've had Rentokil around this week for the ants. Can I just happen to say that I have forgotten tonight the bumper off the Metro? Can you remember the Metro reports that we used to have? Back in 1982, this is probably one of the first songs we ever did. Hey. So, anyway, just if you have got a burglar alarm next to a fire alarm, your brain's going out.
If you get a fire alarm next to an extinguisher, it'll... Valerie!
Oh, no!
Ah!
I was sparking the grill.
Valerie! Someone said it was a bit short.
What's up, Rick? Your arm aching?
Oh, by the way, if anybody wants to go down to Trent Lock and have an absolutely wonderful cream tea, the guy holding the video camera there is Mark, and he serves up a wonderful cream tea.
The old Lock Cottage at Trent Lock, next to the steamboat.
No, it's not a cottage. I wonder what you mean in there.
Lock house. Lock keepers up house.
Yeah.
Mark and Terry, they're down there.
So, if you fancy a locking down the lock keeper's house at Lockington Road.
Dennis Caruso. Valerie!
Oh, no! I was just going to say, that Mark does a lovely cream tea according to his missus. The last time she had a cream tea from Mark, she went...
Valerie!
Hello! And thank you very much for the fine tomorrow.
Don't want to do it now. Valerie! Right, last time, didn't we, eh?
No, yet. Where's this one?
Where from? Up tempo a bit, John, just right there.
Another way. Thank you.
Andy's gone quiet. That's very unusual, isn't it? Fucking hell. We've done that one, I reckon. Now we'll do cardboard, don't forget that. Well, so when you got quiet?
It's the Andy's guitar technician.
I mean, a cable. Look at the bats in the guitar, what a night to go off. I know, we'll do this bass and drums. It's all the rage about new bass and drums. You can do this in 3 hours and get paid more coffee. It's quite good, actually, I think. We'll do this. Oh, it is quiet, isn't it? A fly with a problem.